RPG Maker, a piece of software that lets you create old Final Fantasy style games on the computer and other various game consoles. It comes in many versions, some of which are RPG Maker 2000, RPG Maker 2003, RPG Maker XP, RPG Maker VX, and RPG Maker VX Ace.
And so on and so forth.
Point is, there's a lot of versions. So let's focus on one, the program that made the most recognizable RPG Maker game on YouTube. Yume Nikki, a game that blew up to the point where it got into a Cat Icarus video. And what's funny is, even though it was made in the 2003 version of the software, there are no RPG elements. Yeah, no rocket-propelled grenade gameplay here, pure exploration. Anyway, I'm off track. This is supposed to be an introduction to using the software. The skills you could learn today, tomorrow, I don't know, maybe you've procrastinated or not, I don't know. These skills that you will learn can also be transferred to multiple different versions of the software. They're not completely limited to the version that you're working on. Unless you have like XP or VX Ace where it's RubyScript and it's a C coding language. I don't know. Anyway, let's get started. Woo! Alright, let's get familiar with the tools you're going to need if you want to learn how to make this stuff. Alright, so there's three layers in RPG Maker 2003. The lower layer, upper layers, things that go above the ground, chairs, tables, that sort of thing, and events. The lower layer handles the stuff that the player and events can walk on. The upper layer focuses on props that you make the scene look lively and all that. And events. Oh, this is where the magic begins. If you double click on any tile while in event mode, it creates... Alright, let's take it slow here. So, this is the event editor. This is where everything is controlled when making an NPC or a trigger point. So let's quickly run through the options available. Switch 1 checks if the switch is on or off. Switch 2 does the same thing as switch 1. Variable checks for a variable to activate it. Item, if a player has an item, it will trigger it. Actor checks if a player has a certain character in the party. Timer 1 is a single timer. Timer 2 is a secondary timer. Actor graphic, it displays a graphic actor or items. Movement type selects how you want it to move. For example, random, approach player, etc, etc. Trigger, it's how you interact with the event. Priority, controls where it should be. Below is underneath events and the player. Same as makes it so it has collision, therefore interactable. And above player does what it says on the tin. Animation type. If it's an animated character, you can make it stand still, walk on the spot, and so on and so forth. And movement speed makes it fast or slow. Alright, so that's a lot to take in. The UI is a lot more user-friendly than most other programs like Unity, but let's get into the more complex stuff. Here is the stuff that makes the event work, hence the title. But let's just cover a couple of the common ones that you've probably seen, your average, like, you know, stock standard, trying to test things out, RPG Maker game. Go text, displays text in a dialogue box. Change face set, places a face into any dialogue box after the event is triggered. Conditional branches. I wrote nothing. Basically, they're ways to check whether or not a player has, you know, got a certain thing or is triggering an event or has a certain person in their party and, you know, that sort of thing. Transfer player, it, you know, transfers the player between two separate spaces. At move route, creates a move route for a character or an event to move on. Wait for movement and stop on movement, do what they say on the label. Control switches and control variables, turns on or off, slash swaps the switch state by interacting with it. Race event, it just removes the event. And finally, end event processing, which is, you know, it says it right there. It's right there. I don't know how you don't understand this. Why don't you understand this, man? It's pretty simple shit. And that's not even scratching the surface. There's a lot more commands that I could go into detail about, but I'm not going to for the sake of a shorter runtime. Anyway, yeah, let's move on to... So you probably know how a stage play works. If you don't have actors, you don't have a play. Same goes for this. The Actors tab in the database lets you edit or create new people that will be in your party, and therefore in battle. This can be optional if you just want to have one character throughout the entire game. I'm in charge of what you do. So yeah, now let's move right along to... Alright, basic tools. You got a pencil, which is a pencil. You hold left click in the tile, select it, it will draw it. Well, I'm Australian. Yeah, rectangle tool is a rectangle tool. Okay, most of the map process is what you could possibly do in MS Paint. The oval and the fill tool work here as how they're supposed to. You click on one of the tiles and it will select it, and from there you can go... Same goes for upper layer when doing it with the lower layer. The f*** am I reading? Alright, so, the Resource Manager is where you can import custom content. Now, in the case of RPG Maker 2003, and probably earlier versions like 2000, I'm not quite sure, there is a color depth limit of 256. I'm assuming because, like, older computers and it kind of wants to emulate the style of the Super Nintendo Final Fantasy games, it went for that. I don't know why, personally, I just don't get it. Anyway, other than that, you can put in movie files if you want to in certain versions of the software. For RPG Maker 2003, it's .avi files.
From the earth I rise.
Basically, movies are just cutscenes that you can't skip at all. Like, there's no option for you to skip them. Think of it how, like, you can't really skip a Telltale game cutscene or something like that. I'd recommend that you use a sprite, however you want to say it, to make the sprites that can be used in the game, because, well, MS Paint isn't gonna really get you most places, and, you know, it's MS Paint. We all know it's pretty bad when it comes to, like, artistic drawing and all that. Also, word of advice, don't try to put anything in the folder and expect it to work. You will have to use the Resource Manager, unless you want to get a load of error message that will eventually crash your... And now, to the database! Alright, so this is the last thing I'm going to talk about, because I'm a bit burnt out from writing all this. So the database is the nerve center of the RPG Maker program, where you can edit... Actors, classes, skills, items, enemies, troops, elements, states, battle animations, battle scenes, terrain, and the tile sets. But that's not all! Terms, systems, and common events. Alright, let's go over this stuff slowly. Actors. I've already covered this. Classes. This is required if you want your actor to fight enemies and not be, basically an escort NPC. Skills. Special skills that inflict status or damage while, you know, using MP, or HP if you're feeling spicy in some versions. Items. Read the label on the tin. Can be used for recovery or story progression. Enemies. The tin. Read it. Elements. The type of attacks the actors can use. State. Status ailments and... Battle animation. Okay, so these and the upcoming systems have been split into two because it couldn't fit on the entire window. So, for animations, this one's just player and battle effects. You know, your standard battle screen. Make a battle screen and check the placements using the tab. Terrain. What type of battlefields are used where? Tile sets. Okay, so this is big. So let's break it down. Remember that thing I mentioned a while ago? A pencil, you hold left click in the tile, select it, it will draw it. Well, I'm Australian. Yeah, this is where you make new ones. You can change the possibility of tiles, making so the tile goes above or below you. Make it one-way path, and make small animations, mainly with water. But other than that, it's pretty big. I would recommend looking up how the actual pre-installed tile sets do it. Terms. No, you're not going back to school. This is where the game stores, you know, common phrases like blank, gained, blank, XP, and all that sort of stuff. System 1. This is where the initial party members are stored. What sound effects play where, common screen transitions, title and game over graphics, window graphics, and vehicle graphics. And System 2, it's just, menu items. Battle UI, screen frame, in which I have no idea what it does. Hang on. Even the manual doesn't have insight into this. And finally, common events. This is used to trigger events that can be triggered at any time on any map. And now the rest is up to you. You can create a traditional RPG, make a walking simulator, or some other third option that I couldn't think of because I'm lazy. This has mainly been, like, a point to start from and a tutorial on how to make a full game. So go out, make your own game, don't publish any game on a platform like Steam only using stock assets and copyrighted music. That will get you into major trouble. Either make your own stuff or get some help from a musician or some other profession or a friend when it comes to playtesting. Point is, if you think you need help, ask for help.
Don't be afraid.
Most of the stuff covered in this video... I lost where I was reading. Most of the stuff covered in this video has been documented in the manual. Yes, the software comes with a manual. Shocker. Anyway, that's all I can think of to cover and all that. So, go ahead and create something for someone. Whether it's a friend, family, anyone. Hell, even make it for money if you, you know, make sure everything is original and all that. Anyway, that's all for me. I hope you have a... Oh, wait, I forgot about something. Oh, right, yeah. So you can open a RPG Maker 2003 project by just selecting the folder that the executable is in. It's a good way to get some insight on how things worked. Unless it's in Japanese font, in which you're probably gonna have to install the font, but, that's your own problem. Alright. Well, that's all. See ya. You look to the left, you'll see the tile set selector. You click on one of these tiles, and it'll select it from where you can go. I didn't read that right. There's a color depth of 256. Oh yeah, just like Pac-Man. You can click on one of these tiles, and it'll select from where you want... where you can go. Oh, why am I doing this? It creates... Ah! Find the computer room! Oh man, I'm going insane.